Stay tuned until the end of the video for a very important announcement. You are not going to want to miss this. Hi there! In this video, I'll be doing a watercolor painting for an art contest hosted by Artistically Me here on YouTube. I posted a short version of this video with the song Ocean Eyes by Billie Eilish on my channel. I thought of this painting idea as soon as the song came to mind, and I really love how that video came out, so please check it out once you're done here. If you like painting videos, I highly encourage you to like this video and subscribe to my channel and turn your notifications to all because I have some really fun paintings planned for the very near future. Okay, let's get painting. So the bottle I showed at the beginning is a masking fluid called Liquid Frisket, and it's basically a waterproof gum that keeps whatever part of the paper you apply it to free from paint or water as you're painting. I highly recommend this product. I'll link it in my description if you're interested. In this case, I wanted the hair to be white, but I knew the surrounding area would be blue, so I used this masking fluid to preserve the white area of the paper that would be her hair. You'll see later that parts of her hair did in fact get blue paint on it, but that's not the masking fluid's fault. I applied it with a rubber tip tool, and I think a brush would have worked better for larger areas of coverage. Because of user error, the masking fluid did not cover the entire area I wanted, but that was totally my own fault. I started out a little differently than I normally do with the eyes. Normally I start with painting the skin, but this time I wanted to get the eyes established before starting the skin, because I always end up losing the features when I paint skin first. Since about half of this girl's features are going to be underwater, I had less to worry about. I did the shadowed area of the eyes by wetting the area with water first and adding gray to the upper waterline and letting it blend itself out towards the middle of the eye. After it dries, I add a couple more layers of gray just to build up that shadow. I do the same thing with the skin, wetting the paper and adding color to certain areas and letting it blend out. I tried not to do a flat wash of color because I wanted to try to keep some areas highlighted, and that means letting the white of the paper shine through. After that first layer dries, I repeat the process, except this time the color I'm using is slightly darker and I don't let it blend out as far as the first layer. And I keep doing that until I'm happy with the depth of the shadows on the skin. If certain areas were getting too dark, I just use my brush to mop up the color, but make sure your brush is clean before you do this. So like right below the eyebrow in the middle and also just below the eye itself, I wanted it to be lighter than the corners of the eyes, so I just soaked up the color that was there and blended out the other edges to keep the skin looking soft and realistic. You can also use a clean paper towel to soak up excess color. While the skin is drying, I'll add some color to the background. I'm using a deep blue and turquoise to create an oceany color mixture. Later, I'll add in more varieties of blue and green to give the water some more dimension. With the painting being meant to go along with a song called Ocean Eyes, I really wanted the eyes to be the main focal point and draw your eyes to them. So the colors really needed to pop. I used a neon blue and a neon green watercolor for the base of the iris. My voice is getting gravelly. I used a neon blue and a neon green watercolor for the base of the iris, separately, not mixed together, and later I went in with darker blues and greens on the outer edges of the iris to make the inner colors come across as more vibrant. The watercolors I'm using are the Komorebi Japanese watercolor set, and I really love them. There are 40 colors, including metallics and neons. They are super creamy, not chalky at all, and I highly recommend them to anyone looking for some affordable paints with a large variety of colors. I'll link them below if you want to check them out. I'm not affiliated with anything I link, I just know some would enjoy these paints as much as I do. So now I'm adding in more of that darker shade color, this time with a bit more red mixed in to deepen the color. So gravelly. This part was really fun. I used a technique that I learned for gouache, and that is to put down some color on a dry area and blend outwards from the line that you want to remain hard. So in this case, I wanted the line that was the crease of the eyelid to have a noticeably hard edge, so I blend the color away from that edge and toward the outer corners of the eye. I do blend somewhat towards the middle of the eyelid so the color stays reasonably even, but the center usually catches more light and is less shaded. Of course, this can change based on the eye shape of the character you're painting or whether they have makeup on, where your light source is, or something like that. At this point, I'm happy with the skin tone, so I just keep enhancing the shadows, making them darker, because really what this does is make the character look more three-dimensional, which is what I'm going for. I love realistic looking skin in watercolor, but still being able to see the brush strokes, it's just mwah. Now I'm going over the water area with some water to blend out the initial colors some more, and then lay in some darker tones on top. And also add the water in front of her face. Eventually, the water will be darker in front of her face and get lighter as it goes behind her. The eyes were the most daunting part because I felt they were really important, you know, to the overall look of this painting. I mean, it's for ocean eyes, hello. Yeah, I wanted them to look really good. Here I'm adding in more lines of blue and green to make the water look like it has more movement. I still wet the paper beforehand, but not as much as I did the first time. And the color on my brush is much less diluted, so it's more prominent now, but the edges still blend out into the rest of the background. I really love how the water starts looking as I add in the darker spots, and the water really comes to life once the white highlights get added. For the eyebrows, I made the darkest part at the bottom since that's where I want the shadow to hit. Then I took a flat brush and pulled the color upwards towards the top of the brow to create a soft, feathered, hair-like texture. I'll let that dry and go in later with colored pencils to define them. Brow pencils. Get it? Removing the masking fluid was really easy, I just went slow and none of my paper was ripped. Like I said before, some blue did make its way in the spots I missed with the fluid, but that's okay. I know now I should probably use a brush, one that I'm willing to sacrifice because I'm not sure how difficult this stuff would be to clean off a paintbrush. And now Kiki's eating in the background. I had to put her food bowl next to my desk because we let Sally the dog in and Sally always eats her food. I really like how the darkness of the eyebrows seem to give some weight to the eyes. As a redhead, I have naturally blonde eyebrows and eyelashes, which makes me really appreciate how makeup can help bring out your features that are otherwise invisible. The hair is what I'm least satisfied with. I was hoping for a white blonde look, but it was harder than I thought. I decided to start with a light gray wash and adding some more gray to the eyes since the shadows were not as dark as they were initially. Since the blue bled into a lot of the hair strands on the bottom, I decided to just put more of the watercolor over that area to give the illusion that the hair is just below the surface. I'm using thin streaks of gray to create shadows between strands. Normally I would have them straighter and in more of an organized manner, but I want this hair to look wet and kind of messy. Do you think the hair looks wet? And so it is complete. Again, this painting was for an art competition hosted by Artistically Me here on YouTube. I think I forgot to mention it at the beginning, but the prompt was elements. Can you tell which one I chose? I uploaded a short speed paint video of this painting with the song Ocean Eyes playing over it. I'll have it linked in description land and in the cards, and I'd really appreciate it if you would check it out and tell me what you thought. Okay, now for the special announcement. At the time I am editing this video, I currently have 468 subscribers, which is wild to me, and I really want to do something special for my 500 subscriber milestone. I was thinking I could host an art contest, and the winner would receive a $25 Amazon e-gift card, which is just like a normal gift card, except I can send it to you through email. If you guys like this idea, please let me know in the comments. I won't officially be announcing the contest until I hit 500 subscribers. When I do, I'll make an official announcement video for it. But until then, I will be posting polls on my Instagram, TikTok, and Twitter for what the prompt should be. I'd love for as many people as possible to participate and have a say. I've got plans for even more milestone celebration ideas in the future, and I am super excited about it. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye!